I've helped several automakers with electric vehicle launches during my career. There are a few common questions we expect to hear from anyone who's considering going electric. The first one is usually, how far can this EV go? I've learned that for many people, the magic number which eliminates all concern is 500 miles. Right now, no EV offers that kind of range. Today, most will get you 200 to 250 miles on a full charge at highway speeds. That brings up the next question. Where do you charge it? For most EV drivers, 90% of charging happens while you sleep at a level 2 station you have installed at home. Plugging in quickly becomes a habit, much like most of us do with our cell phones. This next bit is where range anxiety can present itself. What if I forget to charge at home? What if the power goes out? What if you want to go on a road trip? Where do I charge? Those are all very good questions. At the moment, the answer is different for everyone depending on which EV you drive and where you live. The easy answer is you can plug in any EV into any standard wall outlet if you're not in a hurry. We call those slow chargers level 1. You'll gain about 3 to 5 miles of range each hour an EV is plugged in. If you need more speed, you'll want to use a more powerful EV charging station. As of this week, the U.S. Department of Energy reports there are well over 46,000 public charging locations in the United States, with over 110,000 charging outlets available. That figure is surprising and reassuring to most people. Even better, the networks are expanding rapidly. But there's more to the story. Over 80% of the listed public charging connectors are what we call level 2. They're fast enough to charge most EVs overnight, and they're compatible with every EV on the market today. If you're looking for a faster charge, you'll want to plug into a level 3 station, known as a DC fast charger. In the same way some traditional cars run on gasoline and others use diesel fuel, today's EVs support a few DC fast charging standards. One is called the Combined Charging System, or CCS for short. It's the public and open standard, which is supported by all new EVs you can buy in the US today. There are about 3,000 of these public fast charging locations offered by several national and regional networks. The other type of station you might have seen is called Supercharger. Right now, only Teslas can use those. Theoretical maximum charging speeds are similar between the two standards, but some EVs can receive a charge faster than others. Generally speaking, DC fast charging stations work quickly enough to mostly charge an EV in the time it takes to have a meal. Many automakers will bring new electric vehicles to market this year and next. The DC fast charging network's reach, speed, and ease of use will be an important factor for buyers. Today's largest open fast charging network in the US is operated by a company called Electrify America. At the moment, they offer over 560 stations with at least 2,400 DC fast connectors. I've read they'll have 800 stations by the end of this year. They offer plug-in charge technology, which allows many new EV owners to simply plug in and walk away. Billing happens automatically in the background, so drivers don't have to fiddle with an app or a payment card. I like a lot of what Electrify America is doing, and I want to learn more about what goes into building the kind of EV charging network necessary for the whole country to go electric. This week, Electrify America has agreed to pay for my travel from Detroit, Michigan to their facilities in Reston, Virginia, so you and I can learn more from their team of experts. This is Electrify America's Center of Excellence Technology Lab. Before most electric cars come to market, they undergo extensive testing here to ensure they will charge easily and flawlessly on Electrify America's charging network. Commercial, home, fleet, and business-to-business charging technology is also developed here. Let's check it out and learn more. So we're here with Anthony Lambkin, who is the Senior Director of Operations at Electrify America. Thanks for joining us today, Anthony.
Thanks for having me.
Now, is it your view that Electrify America is the market leader?
Yes, I think that's we're market leaders for a number of reasons. We have the fastest charging speed in the industry. We have a coast-to-coast network. A lot of the technologies that you see that are available today, like plug and charge, were pioneered by Electrify America. And of course, we have this incredible investment in our quality and our network performance as well. And all of those things combined make us the charging network of choice for a lot of not only customers and drivers, but also automotive OEMs as well, who are choosing Electrify America to promote their new vehicles through different embedded programs that we have.
We see a lot of new people going electric. So how is Electrify America assisting in those people who come to your chargers for the first time?
So we have a lot of investments in quality to make sure existing customers and new customers have a great experience every time they use one of our sites. We have a whole team in the background called a Network Operations Center that's constantly monitoring the network. They look at 100 different analytical points of data on a daily basis to see how the network is performing, its uptime, its success rate every time someone plugs in, the functioning of different components of the charger itself. And so we're constantly making sure that we're the ones that find out first about an issue on the network and can get out rapidly to fix it before the next customer comes along. We also make sure that we have a world-class customer call center. And so we have a very talented team of agents that are taking calls from customers every single day, helping new customers understand the technology, get charging, troubleshooting different issues with maybe on the charger side or the vehicle side. And so one of the great parts of feedback that we get from customers is how great and how knowledgeable and how custom-oriented our call center is.
Yeah, a lot of people just want to talk to a person too. So
that's right, yes.
It's nice that you have that option here. Mm-hmm. Now, with your role in particular with operations, mm-hmm. you are picking and choosing the locations where these go, is that correct?
That's right. We have a real estate team that consists of analysts that work on all of our mapping to predictively analyze where in the country the next wave of EVs are going to be sold and driven. So we have a team that focuses on not only the analysis of it and the planning of it, but also acquiring the sites across the country as well. So they'll look at a range of different data factors, and then they build models and lay them over maps to say, all right, this particular location in Los Angeles, for example, is where we predict the highest utilization, and therefore the rest of the team working on site acquisition focuses their efforts on finding site hosts with the right amenities, with the right space, with the right power requirements, visibility, etc., that make that site a great site to charge at. Once we know that a site has the right features and amenities and space requirements, and we have an interested site host that wants to host this charging infrastructure, then our installation operations team takes over. They make sure that the site is buildable, that it has access to power, that it is going to be reasonably priced in terms of construction costs. They work with utilities, with permitting authorities. They hire contractors, designers, engineers, and they work with a lot of different stakeholders to make sure that that site is buildable, and then they go and execute on it. That whole process from start to finish takes about 6 months and can take longer depending on how long it takes to energize the site. We have a huge power requirement at our sites. Typically a megawatt plus of energy is needed to be able to power our chargers. And so that takes quite a while to get that power to the site and then get the site commissioned and available to the public.
So there are a lot of those that are on highways and things of that nature, but mm-hmm. what about the rural and remote places? Mm-hmm. What is your take on that?
Yeah. So we started building the network, in fact, much before a lot of the EVs that you see here in the lab were even available. So this was back in 2017. We got our first site in the ground and commissioned in May of 2018, so going on almost 3 years now. And we started laying the groundwork of a national network. Previous to that, all of the non-Tesla charging that was available was all concentrated in metro areas. So the ability to drive coast to coast and having that freedom wasn't there for your average EV customer. And so we began blanketing the country across interstate highways to get our first coast-to-coast route, which we did last year. And now we've got a couple of ways that you can get across the country on our network. And from the early days, we've then begun to increase our footprint in metro areas, in urban, dense urban areas. So we're in about almost 30 metro areas right now with our charging infrastructure, and we're continuing to expand that number into more and more metro areas as we go. One of the other things that we've got to be cognizant of is that now that EVs are proliferating everywhere, they're also outside of some of the markets where we exist today. And so now we're looking at what regional routes do we need to connect other major cities? What other major cities in the US are we not in right now? And how do we begin to lay the groundwork to be able to connect more parts of the US, more destinations, more regional routes, and also other metro areas where these cars are being sold?
Now, I've seen some photos with what looks to be like a solar canopy. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we launched our first solar canopy last year. It's in Baker, California. It has about 70 kilowatts of solar at the site. We also have battery storage systems at Baker as well, but also 70 plus other sites around the country where we use that technology to be able to offset our needs, our power needs from the grid, and help us control some of the demand from the utilities. We are now working on a number of other canopy projects around the country, and we've got a few more in the works in California right now.
Well, thank you for spending some time with us today, Anthony. We really appreciate it. All right, now I am joined by Amy Soderquist, who is one of the commercial business development managers at Electrify America. Thanks for joining us today, Amy.
Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. Let's hop right into this. Can you give us a little bit of background about this division of Electrify America? Because Electrify Commercial is a new part of the company, correct?
Our business is focused on leveraging all the things that we do for ourselves as Electrify America. Site acquisition, testing of vehicles, deployment of new technologies, all of those aspects, and instead focuses on being able to turn those around and offer them to commercial customers who are looking for custom solutions for their own charging networks.
So what would you say the advantages are with working with Electrify America's commercial division?
So that's a really great question. In the same way that we maintain and we operate and we test our equipment and make sure that our public charging network is of the highest quality it can be, we bring that same level of detailed care to all of our commercial customers. So they know that when they're signing up and purchasing something from us, the folks that we hire and use to maintain our own equipment, that we use to monitor our own network, are doing the same exact thing with the same exact level of care for our commercial customers as we do for our own. So everything that we do for ourselves and has earned us accolades in the industry, we offer to our commercial customers as well.
Yeah, and it sounds like since you have a lot of this stuff figured out already, it saves a lot of time for them as well.
Exactly. If you know that your vehicles charge on our charging stations out in the public, it's not a huge stretch to then deploy our chargers at your dealerships, for example. Or if you're wanting to create a network of your own for just your automotive, your automotive company's vehicles, we can do that. And you know that they'll charge both at the private stations you might deploy, as well as at our public network.
So you mentioned a couple of people that you work with. Can you kind of give us a little bit more information, for example, on that Jeep one?
Sure. So the Jeep charging network, Jeep 4xe charging network more specifically, is a network of about 35 sites that we're acquiring for Jeep. And then each location, we're going to be deploying two level two units for the exclusive use of Jeep Wrangler 4xe drivers. So those drivers are going to be able to find those sites close to the Badge of Honor trails across the country, and then charge up their plug-in hybrid Jeep Wranglers, and then go all electric off-roading, something that the Jeep team is particularly excited about.
What would you say your future goals are for this division, Electrify Commercial?
Well, that's a great question. So some of our future goals are to expand what we do both with automotive companies in some different ways, and I'll get into that, but also customers, for example, who are other utilities. So continuing that direction that we've gone already with Arizona Public Service and New York Power Authority, So especially as you look at California and see how the laws there have changed, you know, requiring all electric semi trucks or medium and heavy duty delivery vehicles, those customers in California are needing to figure out how to transition their fleets from diesel, natural gas, or regular just gasoline over to something that's more sustainable. So we're looking to assist those customers in identifying their charging needs, deploying them, figuring out how to potentially get them access to our stations if it makes sense, but then also building stations specifically to serve those customers as well. Also then in terms of what we do for automotive companies, you can see an example of what we've done with Jeep as one way that we can do that. Sort of creating these custom mini networks for those customers, whether it's for a plug-in hybrid vehicle or whether it's for public charging as well. Then we also have what I primarily spend a lot of my time on, which is dealer charging. So with all of these automotive companies coming into the market with new electric vehicles, their dealer networks across the country need to be able to also prep those vehicles for sale and therefore have charging at the dealerships. So how do you take a company that's been used to selling gas cars and is used to just filling them up as they go and being done in 10 minutes, how do you help them reassess how they're going to be charging these electric vehicles that they then need to be able to turn around to sell? So that's something I spend a lot of my time on, is both educating automotive companies about what their true needs are for dealer charging, but then also assisting the dealers and educating them about what electric charging is and helping them find the right solution for their dealership.
So for anyone that owns property or manages properties, how can they find more information about you guys?
So those customers, as well as any others who are interested in the B2C side of Electrify America, Electrify Commercial specifically, of course, if they're interested in finding out more about some of the projects that we've done, looking at our news releases, press announcements, all of those details, they can go to electrify-commercial.com and read about those projects, as well as find the contact us page, which gives you a direct route to essentially my inbox and those of my colleagues. So electrify-commercial.com is the right place to go.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much, Amy, for joining us today. We are looking forward to seeing your guys' progress. Everyone on the team was so helpful, and we learned so much from the team here at Electrify America, so we really appreciate that.
I had a good time. Thank you.
As you know, a tidal wave of electric cars, trucks, vans, and semi-trucks will flood the market over the next 2 or 3 years. We'll need millions more charging stations in homes. Plus, President Biden has set a goal of adding 500,000 more public charging stations by the year 2030. A great deal of planning and technological innovation required is happening right here in this very building. I'd like to thank Electrify America for inviting me here today, where I've learned so much about what goes into going electric behind the scenes.
Always working on new projects to film. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss my next video.